For 7 seasons, Chelsea Handler starred in her wildly popular late-night show, Chelsea Lately.
You're not their mother, you're dating.
She shared her bold take on everything from pop culture to relationships to politics. She's the best-selling author of 6 books on her life, her antics, and her philosophies, with titles such as Are You There, Vodka? It's Me, Chelsea, shocking and charming her way into stardom and the audience's hearts, including my own.
Well, we might have to address the fact that we call each other sissy.
Well, sissy means like we're sisters. Your sister, I call all the people in my life who are sisters sissy. And when I met you and your sister, it's like we bonded over the fact that we were so happy to have sisters in our life.
And now she's back on stage with an HBO Max special called Chelsea Handler Evolution, a deeply personal and deeply funny take on dating, love, and her frequent visits to therapy.
Really tricky time right now. I figured it was time to go to a real therapist. He said, I think you lack empathy.
It's been 6 years since your last special. Why did we have to wait so long? This special is called Evolution. Talk to me about how you've evolved in the last year.
Well, I was able to put it down in a book, and then I thought, if I could turn this into a stand-up show, and that would make me interested in going back to stand up. You know, if I could take this narrative of going into therapy, of realizing I had like, you know, a total attitude problem, I thought, oh, I'm just great. I'm really honest and I tell people the truth. What's everybody's problem? And therapy to me was just one of like the most ridiculously funny, embarrassing, humiliating experiences that you drive to and you go to repeatedly just to pay somebody to tell you what's wrong with you, which is a great transaction. And so I was like, I have to tell the story on stage because it is all the things I love to share, which is the ultimate personal story.
This special Evolution is really beautiful. And there's a poignant moment where you talk about losing your brother. Why did you feel like you needed to go there?
I wanted to do it in an authentic way and be honest about my experience. A lot of my anger came from, you know, my brother dying when I was 9 and never resolving that because I was just a little girl. So it was important for me to like tell that story on stage and kind of take that moment and play with it in the form of stand-up. We had a great little relationship. You know, it was so fun because he was the oldest and I was the youngest and we were like bookends. He was the biggest imprint of my young years.
What was it like to stand on that stage for the first time since the pandemic?
Well, it was great to accomplish something during the pandemic because I just wanted to get this special out before the election, and it was just relevant to this time. We picked this outdoor venue, and it's the city skyline of New York that I was looking at performing yes. to, which was beautiful. And the audience was socially distanced and wore masks. I wanted to bring something to the table during this really dark time that we're all in. You know, I wanted to bring laughter and joy.
And she reliably doesn't hold back from sharing her feelings for New York's Governor Andrew Cuomo.
So while you were staring at that skyline, were you fantasizing about Governor Cuomo? We're 7 months into the pandemic. Do you still have a thing for him?
Listen, I had very strong sexual feelings for him.
And a lot of women are feeling it. When he came on the scene, he looked like the Incredible Hulk also. You know, that big Italian gorilla. I want him to flatten my curve and then I want to flatten his curve.
Yes, I was very sexually attracted to him.
Has he reached out to you though?
I had an exchange or two with him, yes.
Could there be a date? I think the man's single.
Is he single? Yeah, I think he is single. Oh, there has not been a date, though. No. Jenna, I would tell you.
I know. Have you gone on any social distance dating?
Yeah, I have had a couple of dates. The great thing about COVID is if you're not interested in the guy, you can just be like, I'm social distancing.
Goodbye.
Nothing to report, but I'm on the hunt.
Kind of felt like you were because I was looking at your Instagram and you posted about 50 Cent and I'm like, she's reliving these good old days. We got to find her a new man.
No, I'm hanging on to the past, girl.
Sissy, I miss you, and this special is going to make people laugh and fill them with joy at a time I think we need it the most.
Okay, I'll see you next time, Sissy. Love you.
Love you.
Oh, I know.
Are we a little jealous? I mean, we thought we were sissies. Jealous.
Y'all are sissies too, okay. but nobody can take Chelsea's place. Well, I'm just kidding.
Here's what's cool about you and her together. I know that Chelsea's made kind of poked fun at your dad on occasion, and you guys
did she?
You didn't.
I'm just kidding.
But anyway, you guys are still pals, regardless.
Yeah, you know, I actually asked her about that. I said, yeah. Like, how important is civil discourse, loving somebody, even though you may not agree on everything.
Yes.
Because I think we post things on, you know, that our opinions, and we don't make room for people that think differently. And she's like, you know what? You're my sissy. We may not agree on everything, but we agree on what matters the most, that we take care of each other, that we like each other. And so anyway, she is very funny, and her new special, Evolution, is available on HBO to stream right now. She might have gotten in a little Twitter war with 50 since this has happened.
I think so. Yes, she did.
Since this has happened, but we'll leave that to Twitter, right?
That's right.
Exactly. You might have to have an updated piece tomorrow on this whole story, Jenna.